DJ Williams, Doug Williams Jr. I've been coming to this camp for forever. Doug Williams' son. Right now, I'm the assistant quarterback coach for the New Orleans Saints.
How is it that Doug Williams, who has been retired from the game for over 30 years, still a big influence on these young kids' life?
Well, I think some of the kids don't even recognize how much of an influence he is. I think it's up to the parents to let these kids know about the history, right? Nowadays, all they know is Pat Mahomes, Lamar Jackson, Jalen Hurts. But I think in today's game with today's kids, they don't understand it would be none of those guys without this guy who's putting on this camp, Doug Williams, this guy on my shirt, man. So they need to understand. I think a lot of kids do just because he's from this area. I think a lot of kids in this area do understand the magnitude of Doug Williams just because their parents instilled in them what Doug Williams meant to this community. But I think we can do a better job of educating the guys and letting them know really who started this whole thing and who started the black quarterback ascending to greatness. People like Warren Moon, Shaq Harris, and obviously Doug Williams.
Rohan Davey, Ascension Christian Head Football Coach.
Why is it that after 35 years, the name Doug Williams still holds so much praise?
Good question. Well, besides the fact that he was the first black quarterback to win the Super Bowl ever, and then the simple fact of how he stayed connected to the community here in Baton Rouge, how he stayed connected, especially to the black community, with things such as this as free camps for the community, and the work that he's done within the NFL to help not only his players that he played with in the days, his back player, but also the NFL Players Association, that they're actually the one that governing body of the NFL players. And just how he was instrumental with that, everything he's done in Washington. So it's basically just everything that encompasses him, not just as a pioneer of someone who started this thing with black quarterbacks, but also what he's done after football.
As a former black quarterback, how did Doug Williams pave the way for you?
Well, anytime you see somebody that look like you doing something, it motivates you and it inspires you. So for me, coming up and playing quarterback and people telling you, oh, you're not smart enough because you was black, or, you know, you're not intelligent, you're not smart, you can't learn it, that type of thing. They just look at your physical ability. So to see him win it as a black quarterback and excel at doing it in a time where he wasn't welcome, black quarterbacks weren't welcome, especially when he was doing it. So for me to see it, any little struggle that I went through, I just thought of what he went through. And it was nothing near what he went through, what I was going through. So if it, putting myself in his shoes, if he can do it, I can do it. So it was that type of mentality.
In today's league, we're seeing more black quarterbacks coming up. What are some words of advice that you would tell, like, upcoming quarterbacks in high school and middle school? Like, what encouragement would you give them?
You know, because of how the game is changing, football has changed so much since Doug played, since I played. Now it's quick and fast, everything. So for the up-and-coming quarterbacks, I would tell them, stay limber. Stay being able to run. But also, work on the little things that your athletic ability don't show. Work on drops in the pocket. Learn on throwing from the pocket. Because football is still, you got to still catch the ball, still got to drop back, still got to throw, and still got to catch. So I would just tell them to just work. Keep working. Don't ever stop working.
I go to Northwestern Middle. I'm 12 years old, and I'm in 7th grade.
When you hear the name Doug Williams, what do you think of?
I think about a quarterback who kind of paved the way, a black African-American quarterback that gave everyone, like, inspired people to know that they can do their dream and do what they want.
What are you most excited about today?
Being able to come out here and work with some of the NFL talent so I can, like, know what it takes to get there and what I'm supposed to do.
What does it mean to you to see Doug Williams still come back home and give back to his community?
It kind of shows that he like wants to give back to the community because he wants us to have the same opportunity that he has.
My name is Casey Andio, 11 years old, 6th grade, go to Cochran Elementary.
Today you are on the field with not only a Super Bowl champion, but the first African-American quarterback to win the Super Bowl. What does that mean to you?
it means a lot to work with somebody as great as he did in the NFL. As you said, he was the first black African-American quarterback to win the Super Bowl. So it means a lot to work with somebody like him, the inspiration, and I look forward to the rest of the day in the camp.
What are you most excited about today?
All the drills.
If you could ask Doug Williams one question, what would you ask him?
What was it like under the pressure in the Super Bowl?
My name is Justice Flowers, and I'm 10 years old, and I'm going to Coppermill Elementary, and I'm in fifth grade.
What are you most excited about today?
Just to play football.
What does it mean to you to be on the field with Doug Williams?
It's kind of inspiring because he was the first black quarterback to win a Super Bowl, and that's pretty rare.
If you could ask Doug Williams one question, what would it be?
What can I do to get better?
My name is Skylar Booker. I go to, I'm in seventh grade. I go to Northwestern Middle School. And
today you are on the field with not only a Super Bowl champion, but the first African-American quarterback to ever win a Super Bowl. What does that mean to you?
It means a lot to me. It means a lot of me to be known by that person, and it's a good feeling.
When you hear the name Doug Williams, what do you think of?
A legend, for a great person and all.
If you could ask Doug Williams one question, what would you ask him?
How did it feel to be the first African American quarterback to win the Super Bowl, and what did you have to go through?
How you doing? My name is Aaron Brown. I'm the assistant wide receiver coach at Southern University, and I'm going into my second year.
Why is it that after 35 years, the name Doug Williams still holds so much praise?
Man, he's legendary. First and foremost, I was already familiar with him. I grew up on in his neighborhood. I went to Northeast High School, but his name, Doug Williamsfield, is what our football field was. And everything. I just remember, like, man, I'm taking it back. I'm going off topic because I know this man since I was little. But, like, his name hold weight, man, because to me, he a pioneer of the game, especially for the black community. He was, like, the first black African-American to win the Super Bowl, man. That just, like, ignited the whole community. So, for me, I just think that thing right there alone, man, is very solid. And, you know, his name will be forever mentioned in the black community and all over nationally.
What has Doug Williams done for the game of football and young black upcoming athletes?
Oh, man, he opened gates for the game for young black athletes to be quarterbacks, not just skill guys at the position, not just to be, you know, receivers or running backs, skill guys, man. He opened the doors for, like, you know, we can have black quarterbacks too. You know what I'm saying? Because at one part of time, you know, back then it was just like letting white quarterbacks control the team, and, you know, like, just like that we weren't smart enough to control the team. So he opened numerous doors, not just on the football field, but, like, in the communities, open camps, speaking and engaging and things. You know, his like I said, like, he opened tremendous doors for us, and, like, today we got a lot of black athletes that came.
I'm Ken Anio, sports performance trainer in the Baton Rouge area.
When you hear the name Doug Williams, what do you think of?
When I hear Doug Williams, I think of a legend. I had the opportunity to coach with him under him for 3 years at Grambling, so excellent leader, and just the standard of, you know, what every guy, every African American young man should model themselves after.
Hi, I'm Doug Williams, Zachary, Louisiana, 67 years old, and it's been a great day.
How does it make you feel at the age of 67, you still are and have a big influence on so many young black athletes?
Well, number one, you know, I don't worry about the age as much as what you've done in your lifetime and the fact that you can come back and give back like we're doing today. That's what it's all about. It's not about the age. It's about the young people that was out here today, and I think that in itself speaks volumes.
Politicians, I'm trying to change the image. You can't blame my past no more. I come from the trenches. Some said I'd never be a superstar, but I know I'm different. I'm the voice, but the system ain't give me a choice. Know some people that still undeployed. I know a felon who trying to get void. Child support, your only support. For a visit, I'm going through courts. Went to jail, they was chaining me up. And you know that I'm famous as fuck. See how you gon' joke about stimulus, but they really had came in the clutch. I know some kids wanna hurt themselves. Stop trying to take drugs, I refer to myself. Trying to better myself, trying to better my health, but all my life.